What's good, your brother, Evan, bro? Whoa. What's good, your brother, Hollywood? KT, we back with another match. We no cap today. We got two true horror story anime for a game. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share to the video. No cap. The Figure and the Clown.
My name is Sky. And it's good, I'm Sky. I'm going to tell you something that happened to me when I was young. It was May of 2011, and I was only 4 at the time. I was at home with my Uncle Jason, as my mom had gone out with friends and said she probably wouldn't be back until 5 a.m.
Okay.
So my uncle and I stayed up all night watching movies. I eventually got tired and told my uncle that I wanted to go to bed. At around 3 a.m., I woke up for no reason at all, and I looked out.
What the hell?
I saw a figure standing in the middle of the road. At first, I thought it was my mom and her friends, but then I knew
that don't look like no mom.
Only one person. Suddenly, in one swift movement, the figure ran to my window and tapped at it with a fast speed with his slender finger and kept saying, "I'll be coming every night and I will get you, Sky."
What the fuck?
It knew my name. When the tapping slowed down, it made a very loud, ear-piercing scream, and then it faded away. It took me a few minutes to gather my strength to move again, but once I did, I ran to my uncle and shook him awake. I told him what I saw. He looked at me and asked me what he looked like. I described him the best I could, and that's when he told me
what
I saw was a person of some kind who was going to seriously hurt me. He meant kill me, but he didn't say that because I was so young. And he said he would always protect me and he would always be here for me.
What the fuck?
It's been 10 years since I saw that man, and my uncle died in September. I still haven't told my mom about this, but I plan to one day. But I still dread to think, what would have happened if my uncle wasn't there? And if the man had managed to get into the house?
What the fuck? Yo, that picture is crazy. Clown horror story. Okay.
When I was 23, I went to Florida to visit my friend Sophie. Sophie was my best friend in high school, but in the 11th grade, she moved to Florida because her dad was busy with his business. So after a long time of not seeing her, we decided to rent a cottage together for a month. We were searching
for a month,
but almost all of them were too expensive, until we found one that only cost $2,000. Me and Sophie thought it was nothing, especially for that area. So we considered ourselves lucky and rented it right away. The next day, we went there, and the guy introduced us to the cottage. We handed him the money, he handed us the keys, and he left. We then went to go buy stuff we needed at IKEA. 3 days later, weird things started.
You didn't do your research on the neighborhood?
Me and Sophie were sleeping in our rooms when we heard this noise at the front door. It sounded like a clown laughing. Sophie went to see, but she didn't see anything. 4 days later, Sophie went to go buy groceries and I was watching TV when I heard the same.
Why you ain't go with her? Lazy.
But again, nobody was there. Some time passed and Sophie came back with the groceries. We started cooking until we heard that same noise again. But this time we heard something else too. It sounded like something sharp scraping against the door. And we heard laughing and someone said, "It's the police, open up."
Don't open.
Sophie grabbed a knife for protection. She opened the door.
You're an idiot. Look through the fucking people, you fucking idiot. Oh my god.
The clown had sharp scissors and the clown was going to stab Sophie. But Sophie was faster and she stabbed him in the leg. Then me and Sophie ran as fast as we could to the basement and slammed the door shut, locking it tight. Then we called the police. While Sophie was calling the police,
Shit.
I saw a hand in the garbage bag. I opened the bag.
Why the fuck did you open the bag?
I saw a body that was eaten alive. Sophie saw it and froze. She stopped talking to the police on the phone. Then we heard the clown banging on the door to open up. So scared. Finally, we heard the police shout, "Hands in the air." They told us when it was safe
That's fucked, bro. What the fuck? That's crazy.